Can I start by saying that I welcome the publication by the government of the Living with COVID-19 roadmap? I think it's a valuable contribution to the debate, and it's a valuable contribution to the public in terms of how to deal with this crisis. I also welcome what Minister Donnelly said earlier on. He said that in this chapter of COVID-19, what the state is seeking to do is to open up the country whilst at the same time trying to suppress the virus. I think it's very important that we in this House discuss this issue and how, as a country, we should propose to deal with it. There are very many issues that have to be taken into account when we're deciding as a society how do we respond to the pandemic. Obviously, public health must predominate, but there are other factors that have to be taken into account as well, such as Deputy McAuliffe has mentioned, mental health of younger people in particular, and the economic impact that the restrictions are having on society. Can I say to the outset that I think that there are probably three options that we have as a country, and I think the government has done well in identifying the roadmap that it's setting out in the COVID-19 plan. And can I say at the outset as well, I don't have great wisdom in respect of this matter. None of us in this House is absolutely sure what the correct answer is, because although this is not an unprecedented event, it is an extraordinary event. But like some individuals advocate that we should go down the elimination route, I have great respect for the individuals who advocate that line, but I have to say I'm concerned as to how attainable that is. When you look at how this virus is spreading around the world, when you look at its spread in Ireland, in light of the restrictions that we've been imposing for 6 months, my own opinion, as I say, I could be wrong, is that we're not going to be able to eliminate this virus in the short term from this country. That's just my own assessment. A second option is that what we do is we reduce human activity to a considerable degree in the hope that the human activity reduction will result in a reduction in the caseloads of the virus and obviously in the consequent deaths. And that is something that I think we are seeking to do in a measured way by the government, but we need to recognise as well that there are consequences to that. Deputy McAuliffe mentioned the impact it's having in sport. Like, for the life of me, I can't understand why we can't let children play matches. And if you think about it, like, one of the great public health measures for children is to enable them to get involved in sport. So I think what we learn from this pandemic and our reaction to it is that our response in one area is not risk-free. There is no risk-free response we can take in respect of this virus. But I just am concerned in terms of reducing human activity, if we're going from one level up to another and down again, that it's going to have a consequential impact on mental health and on other public health issues. Like, there are other public health issues facing this country, whether it be mental health or cancer or heart disease, all of them very serious issues. And that's not in any way denigrating the seriousness of COVID-19 as a disease and as a pandemic. I suppose a third option is what the government has set out, which is trying to live with COVID-19 as best we can whilst suppressing it. And that is the approach we have adopted. And I think we need to ensure that that is the measured approach that we deal with. It is obviously going to have consequences for people if it is the case that we're moving up levels all the time in the country. I think as time goes on, we will be able to see, well, what's the impact of moving up a level? Is it simply just going to reduce the numbers in the short term, and then we come out of that higher level, we come down to a lower level, and the numbers come back then? I suppose we're all learning as this develops, and I think it's something that we need to keep a close eye on. But I just would be concerned that we don't try and fool ourselves into believing that we can deal with this pandemic as though it is some other political issue, such as housing or homelessness or unemployment. The language we use in respect of it, Laiscéan Comhairle, is that we're going to fight this. I hear people say we're going to crush it into the ground. I don't think we are ever going to be able to do that. I think we need to recognise that around the world, they have tried to control this virus through coercion and through regulation and through law. Regrettably, that hasn't succeeded yet. Now, that doesn't mean that it won't succeed, and I'm not advocating that we don't go down the route of complete libertarianism where there was no regulation. I believe there has to be strict regulation in respect of it. But I do think we need to recognise that where coercion and where regulation has been used around the world, to date, it hasn't succeeded. Now, I know people who disagree with that may say, well, look at China or look at Taiwan or look at New Zealand. And certainly they are at present in a different position to Ireland. They're in a much better position. Although I must say I'm sceptical as to what is the actual position in China. But if you look at other countries around the world, and particularly in Europe where we are, you can see that notwithstanding the enormous efforts that have been made by societies, by countries, to try to ensure that we get on top of this pandemic, that as the restrictions have been lifted, the numbers have inevitably risen. And why is that? The reason that has happened is because we are social animals. And I know we have to cut down on our sociability, but like we made a decision centuries ago that we were going to live proximate to other humans. That's what cities are about. That's what large towns are about. That's what schools are about. That's what collective community activity is about. So it is very difficult to say to people, pull away from that proximity to other humans. And I think it is a huge ask. We've done extremely well in this country, in my opinion, to date. And I think we should recognise that we've done extremely well. And it is difficult. I know Deputy McAuliffe spoke about sports, and other people have spoken about young people. And I've spoken probably too much about young people. But I think there are two groups that have suffered very much from this. One is young people, but the other is the elderly, who have, I suppose, been put in a position in their lives now where they are very fearful as to going out and fearful as to meeting younger persons and their relatives. And I suppose they have to be very careful. Like the NPHET were before the COVID committee yesterday. They gave us some very valuable information. The median age of the 1,803 people who have died to date is in the late 80s. So obviously, people who are very elderly and elderly people need to be particularly careful. I know it's a dangerous disease that affects everyone, and it is, but people who are elderly need to be particularly careful in respect of this, particularly if they have underlying conditions. So listen, I think the roadmap is a good map. I think we need to give it time. I think we need to listen to the public health advice we are being given. But I also think we need to recognise that we can't close our minds to the societal impact, to the economic impact, to the other public health impacts and the mental health impacts of the restrictions, because I suppose in respect of the pandemic at present, we can see the consequences of the pandemic by looking at the tragic figures of the numbers who have died in Ireland and around the world. But what we can't see are the repercussions of the restrictions around the world and the repercussions of the restrictions here. And they will be measured in mental health, in other public health issues, in the impact on children, and the impact on elderly people, and in sort of moving from a society that we've built up over many centuries. Thank you.